Item number, SCP-3764. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-3764 is to be contained in a standard safe class object container. Request to use SCP-3764 for clinical, utility, or humanitarian purposes are to be sent to the project director, acceptance pending their decision. Instances of SCP-3764-1 are to be regularly distributed to all staff members at meal times, if requested. Standing permission is granted for use as rations for D-class personnel, though special precaution must be taken to provide supplementary food in addition to SCP-3764-1. Description: SCP-3764 is a small burlap sack with cursive writing on the front that reads, "For those in need, a friend," written in the native language of the reader. Illiterate subjects typically see some variation of a simple picture, typically of a steaming loaf of bread. Inside SCP-3764 is a loaf of wheat bread, warm and typically smelling freshly baked, designated SCP-3764-1. When taken out of SCP-3764, SCP-3764-1 will have a small string tied around it, with a note attached to it. The note is personalized to whoever reads it first. Notes typically range from 1 to 2 words in length, though some occasional instances have had lengthier notes. Notes are typically in the most formal version of whatever language they are written in, and are almost always signed "a friend." Some notes suggest that SCP-3764 is conscious, possibly even sapient, as a few notes have been found that spoke directly to Foundation personnel. Notes are always in the native language of the first reader, and do not alter after the first reading. See Experiment Log 3764-1. Once an instance of SCP-3764-1 is taken out of SCP-3764, a new instance of SCP-3764-1 will appear in SCP-3764. The number of SCP-3764-1 instances that can be generated is limited by the number of people within a 200-meter radius of SCP-3764. Initial testing revealed that SCP-3764-1 is safe for human consumption. Subjects who consume SCP-3764-1 describe it as having a pleasant taste. All subjects report a feeling of satisfied hunger, and experienced no feelings of hunger for the rest of the day, coupled with reports of pleasant feelings and reports of a restful sleep. Subjects eating exclusively SCP-3764-1 and water for a period of 3 weeks experience no malnutrition symptoms and could have possibly survived indefinitely until an instance of SCP-3764-1 crumbled to dust when a researcher pulled it out of SCP-3764. Its note read,
"You know what they say, men cannot live on bread alone and all that. Be nice. Variety is the spice of life. A friend."
Instances of SCP-3764-1 continued to crumble when removed from SCP-3764 until researchers included side dishes of fruits and vegetables with them. Experiment Log 3764-1. Subject D-4568 suffers from severe night terrors and sleep paralysis, resulting in sleep deprivation. Result: standard loaf. Note read,
"Sleep well, a friend."
Notes: subject reported a deep and uninterrupted sleep. Requested permission for use of SCP-3764-1 as a sleep aid, which was granted. Subject, D-4678, clinical depression. Result: standard loaf. Note read,
"I care about you, a friend."
Notes: notable decrease in depression symptoms, such as improved hygiene and healthier sleep patterns. Research into possible medical applications of SCP-3764-1 ongoing. Subject, Site-19 personnel who consented to SCP-3764-1 being included in their cafeteria meals. Result, pleasant effects resulted in increased adoption by other members of the staff. Latest psych evaluations show a notable increase in morale. Notes: proposal for SCP-3764-1's use as field rations for MTFs submitted by Project Director to Foundation leadership. Subject: D-8934 and D-8942 in cell block F cafeteria. Result: D-8934 was accidentally overlooked during a handing out of SCP-3764-1 instances, and the guards left without giving him anything. D-8942 noticed this and tore his loaf in half to share with D-8934. The two halves spontaneously became whole instances of SCP-3764-1. Notes: while not intentional, this incident possibly shows further evidence for SCP-3764 having consciousness and situational awareness. Subject: D-8654 and D-8681 in cell block K cafeteria. Result: D-8654 asked to read D-8681's note, who declined. D-8654 forcibly seized the note, and upon attempting to read it, the note read, "Be polite. A friend." Notes: description updated due to new data. Subject: D-3457, convicted of multiple homicides, reportedly suicidal. Result: standard loaf with note that read,
"Eat and live. You owe them that much. A friend."
Notes: no further reports of suicidal activity. Subject taken off suicide watch by psych team. Subject: D-4561, convicted of a string of rapes and murders of small children. Result: SCP-3764-1 instance came out of the bag charred black and crumbled to ash upon being touched by D-4561. The note read,
"Sweet dreams. Not your friend."
Notes: subject was very shaken by incident and went to bed shortly after. Upon falling asleep, the subject began screaming in their sleep, presumably having a nightmare. Every attempt to wake D-4561 failed, including a powerful electric shock. 14 hours later, D-4561 woke and began whimpering incoherently for the rest of his waking hours. D-4561 was hysterical in his desire not to go back to sleep, and eventually resorted to self-harm in an attempt to prevent himself from falling asleep. D-4561 was moved to a special containment cell for his own safety and to monitor his condition, which remains unchanged to date.